尊敬的各位李本山先生的亲朋好友，我是前天从北京专门回来，我想利用这个机会呢，请允许我表达来纪念一下李本山先生。我认识他呢，认识秘密呢，是30年前，1980年的时候。那么我1990年的时候呢，刚到美国的时候呢，我住在李先生太太的家里，3个夏天。从那时至今呢，我们的来往关系非常的密切。我基本上是每年呢，我都到他家里，起码2次住到他家里。然后呢，我在俄亥俄读书呢的时候，夏天就过来。然后到纽约，在哥伦比亚大学读书，然后毕业到大都会博物馆工作，还到波士顿博物馆做研究员，现在呢，在北京做些这个文物的鉴赏研究。我想用这样的一个机会呢，想一想哪些最重要的东西呢？李本堂，你先生教了我，我想简单说两件事儿。不能说太多。一件事儿呢，就是刚才这个大家这个亲自的讲了，他教开车这件事儿。我90年刚到美国的时候啊，他教我们开车，那时候是在这个 horseback。李本堂真的是一个非常好的老师。那90年的那个秋天呢，我跟他就是那些范先生讲同学会，您可能没在。我和他还他的岳父开车到 San Francisco， 开回来的时候，快到家的时候，我穿过路口的时候，穿路口的时候呢，可能是2趟线，我就把车呢，可能不过路口我就跑到旁边那个先生去。大家知道啊，先生是有脾气的，先生马上把我给叫停了，他停下来，就跟我说，他说你知道我出了一件事。我说什么事故？我说夜里半夜1-2点没人呢。他说你已经回归了，这是2趟线，你穿到那趟线去了。李先生教我，是我一辈子最不能忘记的话。他就说，他说这个第一，开车要守规矩，车身就是你的身体。第二一点，要时刻的小心呢，你周围的人违规会影响到你。这两句话影响我一辈子，不光是影响我开车，还影响我工作。所以当我在工作的时候，我去了这么多的单位的时候，我都记住李先生的教导：第一，自己守规矩；第二，要考虑周围的人破坏规矩的时候会造成什么影响。这是第一点。再有一点，就是说刚才讲的这个读书的时间呢很长，但是我没他读得多，他比我读得多，比我读得多。有一件事呢，就是刚来的时候呢，他叫我去，他说你应该去到餐馆打工，你可以住到我家里，我住在豪华的房子里，然后开那个双双的 scooter 去餐厅打工。这是我到现在我觉得学的最多的，在餐馆里。一张照片呢，大家可能看到，就是我们在餐馆去打工，一家里人呢都跑着去给我们捧场去。你知道我是从大陆来的，我们是受的这个共产主义教育，共产党教育。我经常跟老板要拌两句嘴，平等啊，对话。这里的老板曾经骂我是共产党。我说我连申请书都没写，我怎么是共产党的？我说我不是。说李先生呢，刚我洗脑子呢，就洗掉了大陆那些学生学者的那种习惯，不守规矩，跟老板对抗。那么我在这里这么多年，头一个事情李先生让我学的，就是怎么尊重老板，怎么尊重负责任的人。这是一个非常对我一生呢非常重要的事情。 所以这个给我两分钟、三分钟不能都说完，是吧？如果我是李先生讲的话，他没有特别大家讲话的机会。我经常听李先生讲，所以有人开玩笑啊，说你是学者，李先生是教授，他真是教授。我在他家里的时候，基本上我很少说这么长时间，大部分时间都他说。而且他说呢，他不光说结论，今天我讲结论，他讲过程，他讲推理，他讲思考的整个的一个系统。这个文字里边写的很多都是秘密的语言，我想他这里边说，可能因为你现在讲话的时候，有的人听得不舒服。我说没有，我听得特别舒服，而且我学了特别多的东西。正像您刚才讲的一样，我在这里学到的这些华人，他们比大陆的人爱国，比我这人大陆的人爱国。为什么？我一本堂是，所以他是代表。但是他爱国呢，不是出于一种感情激动，他是非常有知识。刚才一位这个政大的老师说的，我专心的听啊，我是学者，学者有两种，一种是讲给别人，我是学生的人，学习的人，我学了很多。因为他对边疆的历史，对西藏的历史，对朝鲜的历史，我问他什么，他77岁的人的脑子像计算机一样，他要从头给我讲，讲到夜里的3点。我说李先生，我还得睡觉呢。这是我永远纪念他的，感激他的地方。我也答应他，我说我在北京啊，我想有机会的时候，只要是我有条件的机会，我请你去啊，到北京讲。你这里讲就这么几个人，他们时间就少了。是这件愿望呢，没能得以实现，还是我们准备的方法，继承李先生的遗志。这个还有一点我想说，这个李先生呢，这个跟李太太他们两个人呢，真是最好的夫妻，是模范。而且李先生的成就啊，李先生都跟我说，也得感谢咪咪对他的这个照顾支持，他们两个是配合，真的配合。这也是从中啊学到，包括我的太太，我们学了很多的东西，从李先生和李太太身上。我不能说太多了，时间到了，谢谢。
Ever here today, I'm standing here to Eminent Father, who's in the country, is never up to me personally, but he has meant so many things to so many people. We can all certainly share memories of how he touched our lives. For me, there are a few memories that I like to share. Ever since I was little, he always preached the importance of hard work. With a do-it-yourself attitude. And he certainly led by example. Being a minority while working at a large company at NCR was not very easy. Facing discrimination and pressures of layoff, he would continue to work long hours and overtime, even nearing retirement, so he can retire on his own terms. After hours on weekends,It would also help with mom's growing business. With any free time left, he would tirelessly work in the yard, hauling cinder blocks, mixing concrete, building retaining walls all by himself. It seemed that he could do it all. This has definitely rubbed off on all of us to become more independent and hardworking in our own endeavors.He was also very passionate about learning and education, and had a tremendous love for math and history. And that certainly rubbed off on us as well. If you ever ask him to help with any math homework, he will explain everything you need to know, and even things you don't, just to get the point across. Any chance he got, he would sit down and tell us in colorful detail.Segments of Chinese history from the beginning of time. First the textbook version, then the real folklore version. If you let him, It would never stop. This passion also extends through his dedication to the Chinese community. As we can see here today, the turnout is tremendous. He could be seen setting up a booth at a fair during Chinese New Year celebration, or at a meeting supporting a fellow Chinese running for office, or just conversing or debating with friends about recent Chinese politics. Quite often, as been said here before, these conversations may turn very loud, and after some alcohol, he would start to debate in English. Most importantly, he dedicated himself to his family. Beyond the immediate family, he would go out of his way to help with extended family members as they adjusted to the move to America. He would find time to take trips to visit his mother in Vancouver, often cooking her favorite dishes. He would also help care for his younger sister in LA during her bouts with illness, often calling her every day just to check in. Though he did not show overt emotions often to us, on the exterior, we knew he cared deeply about all of us. We will all certainly miss him, and I will certainly miss him and love him as well.
Thank you all for coming here today to celebrate my father's life and for your prayers, support, and kind thoughts during this difficult time. Many people helped to make this memorial service so special, and I want to take this moment to express my gratitude on behalf of my family to everybody, especially the committee of 60 people who came together to organize today's event. It was very beautiful. Thank you very much. Community building was always at the center of my dad's mind, and you see the fruits of that labor of love reflected here today. I am also incredibly heartened to share the celebration of my dad's life with his oldest brother, Da Bo, and his family. My dad's oldest sister, Da Gu Ma, and Da Gu Ye, and my dad's younger sister, Agu. 2 nights ago, during dinner together, my Da Bo reminded us how successfully my dad dedicated himself to building U.S.-Chinese relations, and I believe he truly made a positive difference, touching so many lives on both sides of the Pacific. Before my dad passed away, he planned to drive from San Diego to visit my husband Malego, my son Malefo, and me in New York City. My dad wanted to bring us our car, given to me by my brother Warren, present today in spirit. Ever relenting in the duty he felt as a father to help his children, he turned the 2,800 miles that separated us into a road trip. Curious at heart and enthusiastic about geography and history, my dad, with his beloved, my mom as co-pilot, would have set out east to enjoy and learn even more about this vast country, his second home. I am deeply, deeply sad not to be able to welcome my dad with open arms. Say to him, come in, rest, take off your shoes. You can relax now. I am so happy to see you. What a long and exciting journey you have completed. Tell me all about it. You are here, you're with your family, and you're at home. Your grandson is waiting to play with you. So I say these words to him today. You can relax now. You have completed a long and exciting journey. You are here. You are with your family, and you are home. Thank you.
This concludes our eulogy portion. Indeed, Michael, as a curious person, a passionate person, but most importantly, he was our friend. And we will miss him dearly. And we hope that the family members all here today and friends will always remember the kindness, the generosity, the great man he was, my colleague.
Cause I've been searching through my whole life for a place to call my own. Now I finally have found what I love. Among roses, I found my home. But what if nighttime lingers over, stay forever around my heart, and the shadows will all surround me? Could I see though it's all dark? And what if your love goes away now, I find a way through it? Could I live here when you are gone? Here in the garden, among the flowers, smells of roses that fill my head. Now I finally have found what I love. Among roses, I found my home, my home. Now I finally have found my home, my home. Among roses.